Welcome to Season 5 of Public Health On Call, a podcast from the Johns Hopkins Bloomberg School of Public Health. I'm Joshua Sharfstein, Vice Dean for Public Health Practice and Community Engagement and a former health commissioner here in Baltimore, Maryland. Our goal with this podcast is to bring scientific evidence and experience to shed light on critical health issues. If you have questions or ideas for us, please send an email to publichealthquestion@jhu.edu. That's publichealthquestion@jhu.edu for future podcast episodes.
Hi, I'm Lindsay Smith-Rogers, producer of Public Health On Call. Here we go again. In a bonus episode today, Dr. Josh Sharfstein talks to virologist Professor Andrew Pekosz about the latest news on COVID variants, including why the more things change, the more the best advice about safety stays the same. Let's listen.
Dr. Pekosz, it is good to see you, although I'm not thrilled to be here talking about another coronavirus variant. Tell us what's going on.
Well, you know, when Omicron emerged around Thanksgiving in South Africa, three different versions of Omicron were sort of lumped together. They're called BA.1, BA.2, and BA.3. You know, we saw this BA.1 that caused most of the cases globally throughout December and January. And what we're seeing now is BA.2, its sibling, is sort of following along its footsteps and making some inroads in terms of causing cases globally. They're very closely related, but distinct. All the properties of BA.2 so far seem to be very similar to what we saw with BA.1 in terms of its ability to escape vaccines and its transmission rate and its relatively low potential for causing severe disease compared to something like Delta. So it's yet another variant that's working its way across the world. As a virologist, it's not unexpected, but certainly I understand that everybody is a little tired of hearing about variants coming through.
So does it look like the people who had Omicron infection with BA.1 can now just immediately turn around and get infected with BA.2, or is it mainly infecting other people, or don't we quite know yet?
Well, the initial data suggests that if you've been infected with BA.1, you have a pretty good immunity against BA.2. So difficult to predict these things in a pandemic, but my sense is that BA.2 will be moving through populations that are either unvaccinated or haven't been boosted or haven't been infected recently. So the data says BA.1 should protect against BA.2 and probably vice versa as well.
If that's the case, and the U.S. had such a brutal experience with BA.1 with so many infections here, do you think there's a chance we don't see quite the problem that Europe has been seeing with BA.2?
That's certainly my hope, based on the numbers that we're seeing. Now, there are a significant amount of people who either haven't been vaccinated or haven't been boosted here in the U.S., and boosting is really critical for maximizing your protection from either BA.1 or BA.2 Omicron variants. So I am optimistic that there's enough population immunity here in the U.S. to limit virus spread, but we have to remember that this is coming at the same time as we're reducing all of our public health interventions, so there's two things moving at the same time here that may lead to increased cases.
Got it. So it could be just opening up is causing could cause a rise in cases here from either BA.1 or BA.2.
Absolutely. I know there's a feeling that we should always blame the virus or the variant for what's going on, but I think we have to remember that we're in a very different stage now than we were Thanksgiving or during Christmas time when it comes to our public health interventions. And that's going to factor into the case numbers that we see.
Any other variants on the horizon that you're watching? I've heard about deltacron, but I don't know if that refers to one of these viruses we've already been talking about.
Yeah, so deltacron has an interesting history. For a couple of months now, people have been reporting sequences that look like it's a combination of the Delta variant and the Omicron variant. And for many weeks, those were those ended up being just sequencing artifacts and not real viruses. But over the past couple of weeks, a few reports have emerged of viruses that have sequences from both of those variants put together. It's not uncommon with coronaviruses to see this. It's called recombination. We don't know if the threats from this deltacron are very significant right now. It looks like for most purposes, it resembles the regular Omicron. But other than that, there's just been a small amount of changes in Omicron that are occurring that scientists like myself are monitoring, but that aren't coming up to the level that the general public should be concerned about.
So bottom line, the more variants we get, the more some things stay the same, like get vaccinated and boosted.
It's amazing how that message just maintains consistency. We did have to add the booster to deal with Omicron, but at the end of the day, vaccination and boosting is doing a fantastic job of limiting severe disease and an okay job of limiting infection, but it really is the tool to go forward to get us back to normalcy.
So there are some places in the world that are not experiencing normalcy right now. Hong Kong comes to mind, China, where there are major lockdowns. What do you think is going on there?
Well, I think it's probably two major factors. Both of those countries have really tried to practice a COVID zero policy, meaning they've been locked down. They've instituted very strict public health interventions to limit numbers of cases. And Omicron is so transmissible that it's been able to overcome some of those public health defenses that those countries have had in place that worked against other variants. So they're starting to see cases. What they've done for other variants isn't working as well against Omicron, and you're seeing these surges in cases. I think the second thing is both of those countries have issues with their vaccination programs. Hong Kong in particular has a relatively low vaccination rate in their elderly population. And that, of course, is the most sensitive population to severe COVID. And some of the vaccines that have been used in China don't turn out to have as durable an immune response as our mRNA vaccines. So again, it starts with Omicron being just a more transmissible variant than any other one that have come before. And now you have to deal with that in a population that has been relatively protected from other infections. And so it poses a big public health problem for both of those countries.
I want to end with a question, just looking back on Omicron, the number of deaths that we're seeing in Hong Kong from Omicron among older adults. Do you think it illustrates that the story that we were telling ourselves about Omicron being maybe a little milder might have just been a reflection of what that virus was doing in a relatively well-vaccinated population, and that the virus is actually quite serious for people who essentially are naive to coronavirus?
Yeah, I think that's an incredibly important point. You know, Omicron may not be as virulent in people as Delta was, for instance, but it certainly is comparable to some of the earlier SARS-CoV-2 isolates that we were so concerned about when they first entered the population. If you don't have immunity to SARS-CoV-2, Omicron is not something that you should sort of welcome. It is a very dangerous virus, and it's going to continue to target those populations that don't have immunity, because those are the susceptible ones, and those are the ones that the virus can gain access to and spread in.
Well, Dr. Pekosz, thanks. I certainly agree with you there, even if we still can't quite agree on pronunciation. I look forward to seeing you around the school. Hopefully, we won't have too many more encounters talking about potential variants, but it may well happen.
Absolutely. Good to talk to you, Josh.
Public Health On Call is produced by Joshua Sharfstein, Lindsay Smith-Rogers, and Stephanie Desmond. Audio production by Niall Owen McCusker, Matthew Martin, Spencer Greer, and Holly Cardinale, with support from Chip Hickey. Distribution by Nick Moran. Production support from Catherine Ricardo. Social media support from Grace Holz Fernandez. Thank you for listening.